right, guys. So we're down in Kentucky now. We're going to be heading out here in a little bit to the stand. It's been a while since I've been down here, so it's a good feeling. We're going to be in a creek bottom tonight. The wind's blowing perfect. It's cooler than yesterday. It was 98 yesterday, so it was a little bit hot. But tonight, it's going to be perfect. The deer should be moving. We're after a big 10 with a kicker off of his G2, so either that deer or there's a couple other mature deer down here. So stay tuned. That should be a good night. Central Kentucky at Seven Bar Outfitters. We're down here in this creek bottom tonight. It's about 3 o'clock right now. So we've got about 3 hours before the deer move. But we've got corn here. We've got a creek back here behind us. And it should be a good evening. It's been hot the last couple days, they've said. And it's down to like 79 right now, which is still hot. But it's been in the 90s the last couple days. So I think these deer should move. If we see one, I'm not sure. But I know we'll definitely see some deer. If not, the deer we're after. So stay tuned. It should get interesting here soon. Stand for day number two here. We're in a different spot. We're up on top of the ridge this evening in an oak tree. We're up on this ridge, at the end of this ridge here, where the bean field meets the woods. We've got some corn down here. We've got a bean field here. And we've got a little gap in the fence right here behind us. The guys with Antilogics killed one here last year. And it should be pretty good. Should be really good. It's a little bit hot. It was hotter than yesterday. It's about 85, but the deer moved last night right before dark, so crossing my fingers something shows up here, but it looks like a beautiful spot, so we'll keep you guys updated. Thank you.
freaking way. Did you guys see the size of that four point? I can't believe that deer came in. There was a doe here for a long time. I smoked him at 30 yards, dude. This place is unbelievable. I didn't think I was going to see any deer this evening. But lo and behold, this doe came out. And then she saw something down here in the woods. There comes a little buck back. But I saw this deer coming through. I'm like, I know it's him. And they said, shoot him if he comes in. So, you know what I had to do? I just tagged out in Kentucky on a world record.
Way to go.
I think he went up through here.
Up through here. Well, they can look at the doe.
Hey, huh? Look at the tree.
Yep. He's laying right there. Oh, he's laying there. That's your editor.
My heart shot him.
I'll let you go ahead.
Right down through here. Blood.
Yeah, I think blood.
Blood here.
Come on, you can't go right far.
No.
He's got to be laying right there somewhere.
Oh, yeah. That's nuts. Look at the blood splattered on the tree. Oh my God.
So he crashed all right.
Yeah, he did. Oh my God, look at the look at the size of this deer. That is nuts.
That is a deer. Look at what a fucking deer.
That is nuts. Oh my God.
Well, I'm sorry, you video wasn't you?
Oh, it's okay.
Man.
What a four point.
Look at that.
The blade.
Son, ain't that fantastic? Look at that.
Oh, look at this giant. Look at this, guys. This is a four point white-tailed deer here down in Kentucky. I came down with Luke Carswell with 7 Bar Outfitters here, and I've had a lot of bad luck streaks here in Kentucky with outfitters and such, but tonight that changed around here, got the monkey off my back. Before I came down, I saw pictures of this deer, and I asked him, I said, hey, if this deer comes in, can I shoot it? And he said, yeah, go ahead. If he comes in, he's an old deer, he's like 5 or 6 years old, he was a 6-point last year. And he turned into a 4-point of all things. Now, look at the brow tines. These things are huge. Huge bladed brows. He's got a couple kickers down here. And I don't even know what to call these. I don't know if it's 2s, his main beams, I don't know what. But this is a giant, giant deer, an old deer. And I'm happy to take him out and head back home with a smile on my face and some meat in the freezer. So, he came out, I mean, he came out right at last light. There was like 6 or 7 does, another little buck. And a doe came out first, and she looked up and was kind of like surprised. But I saw his tines coming through. I'm like, that can't be that 4-point. But sure enough, here he is. And what a giant, giant deer. So thanks again, guys, for watching the YouTube channel and keeping up with me on Facebook and stuff. So I'm going to get this guy tagged out and get the other guys that are hunting here from Wisconsin to help me load him up, and that'll be the end of the Kentucky saga. So thanks again, guys.